Hello Renderbots, welcome back. My name is James and today we'll be going through the basics of your Mac. So this is for somebody who maybe just bought their Mac, they've taken it out of the box and they really want to know their way around. So I'm going to take you on a quick tour of that. So first of all, as you can see, when you open up your Mac, you first switch it on, you've got this screen in front of you, that's called your desktop. Okay, and this is where we're going to put files and folders when we're using them. Not a great idea to store them on here, but it's where we would normally use them. Down here we have something called the dock, and the dock is basically somewhere we put our applications we use often. Now, as you can see at the bottom, we've got a selection of items already that you may or may not be familiar with. What's interesting is these, we can remove these and add them as and when we wish. So what you see down here is what we call the stock. This is what comes with your Mac, but basically you may want to change these at a later date. One nice thing you may notice is that my dock's quite small. And we can make it bigger by moving our cursor into this little line here. See this little line that changes from a to a kind of double pointer. If I put my cursor there, click and push up, it grows. So all I'm doing is put my cursor from there, click and pushing up and down, and it increases the size of the dock. That's a very quick way of changing what the dock looks like. Up at the top of the screen here, you'll see there's something called the menu bar. And the menu bar changes depending on what application you actually put on the screen. So for example, you'll say it says the word Finder right now. So if I open up Address Book, we'll now see that it says Contacts. Okay, so I'm actually in my contact book here. I still call it my address book, but yeah, it's Contacts. So that's changed because I'm on the application. Now, if I go to Notes, just gonna press Continue here. Just cancel that. Okay, so here's my notes, and that's my contacts. Now, as you see, the menu bar says contacts because I have that selected. If I go to my notes, you'll see now that changes to notes as well. So that's something interesting with a Mac, that it does that. It will change. And the reason why it changes is because we have more options available. So let's go back to my contacts. So you'll see that here's my contacts here. And if I go up to the word file, I can add new card, add new group. Now, this might not make sense to you right now, but basically the menu bar will give us more options than we see initially on this application. So that's our menu bar. Now, the menu bar is separated into two sections, and so far we've spoke about the left-hand side where it will give you more options when you have an application on there. When you look onto the right-hand part of the side, you'll see this is where kind of all the gadgets and gizmos are, things like joining my Wi-Fi. Okay, so when we go to a hotel or something like that, or a home, we click on this little radar button there. It says turn on or off your Wi-Fi. And from here, it's showing us available Wi-Fi points that's in this house right now. So I'm obviously on orange. I've got a live box here, but yours may say BT Internet or some other Wi-Fi there. So that's how we click and join on there. We'll notice there's a little lock on this one to tell me that it's actually a secure network. So I don't need to worry about that right now because I'm actually on, that's my home Wi-Fi. Next to that, I've got my volume button. And again, depending on what you've got connected, in this case, we've got some internal speakers on here. It's actually picking up my AirPods, which are these little fellas here. These are made by Apple, and these enable me to not only use them as a microphone to speak to you, but also I can hear music through these as well. So these are great on a Mac. So you may have some Bluetooth headphones, etc., that you've bought, and that's how it's going to change the volume from it on there. I'm actually using MacBook Pro, which is a laptop, so that my laptop actually carries a battery. So this is why this battery sign is on here. It's telling me that obviously this little thunder flash icon here is that it's charging right now. But if you've got an iMac at home, the one that sits on the desktop, you won't see this battery here. And obviously got a date and a time in there. Okay. And you may or may not have your name listed here. So this is my Renderbots laptop, but obviously I also have another account on here. If you want to know about changing accounts and setting up users, I'll be doing that in another video soon. If not, I'll put a link on it up here once I do that. So that's got my name here because that's who's using the computer right now, but you can share your computer with other people by creating a another account. Really simple to do, and I'll go through that in another tutorial. Here next to that is probably one of the most important buttons, and that is something called Spotlight. Okay, so when I press that, you notice I get this kind of search toolbox in the center of the screen. And the idea with Spotlight is it lets me find any file or folder or even application. Or now, very cleverly, it looks around us as well. In other words, it's an internal search engine of your computer, but you can also search outside. So if I typed in here Starbucks or Costa Coffee, it would actually show me my closest ones. But because I live in the middle of France, there's not that many. In fact, there's more cows around us than anything else. So Spotlight is really cool. It lets me find a folder, and all I've got to do is type in here what I'm looking for. So if I was looking for my address book or contacts, C-O-N-T, and you can see already everything else on my computer that I might be interested in beginning with C-O-N inside there. So it didn't let me sort of finish it. But if I clicked on the contacts now, it would now launch my contacts, which we've already seen. So Spotlight, very, very clever. It can even search email address sort of content, it be a subject matter or who from the email is from as well. So a really clever piece of kit. Next up, I've had the Siri button. Now, Siri is good for lots of different things. So let's see how much room is on my hard drive. So I'm going to press this button now. How much space is on my hard drive?
You have 104.85 gigabytes storage available.
Okay, so if you're coming from a PC or anything else like that, you might find that actually quite cool that it does know how much space is on here. But also I can ask questions like things about the weather, etc., and she'll give me that information. Siri keeps growing and changing, so we'll be doing a lot with Siri on another episode. Next to Siri button here, we have this kind of sidebar button. It's kind of like these three dashes. When I click on it, we see we have some more information appear to the far right. We have what's happening today, stock shares, weather, where I am, lots of information here, notifications. So if you're using Twitter or Facebook, notifications here will pop up and show you things like that. Things in your calendar will also appear here. So this sidebar is really, really handy, but it gets out of the way when I click on that button and bring it backwards and forwards. Again, this is just a quick run through of getting started on Mac, just to show you where things are. There's lots of stuff we can go really in depth and get lost in pretty quick. So I'm just trying to give us a good overview of your Mac going forward. So one thing I always like to tell people about the Mac is understand what you bought. What have you got in front of you? As I said, in mine, I've got this MacBook Pro, but how do I know what it is? What's it running? What operating system is it running? Because operating systems change. In other words, the computer we're using here has software on there and it's of a certain specification. We kind of we need to understand why that what's on there and why we have it. So the way we can do that is go to our Apple sign here on the top left-hand corner. When I click on this, you'll see this thing which says about this Mac. Let's give that a click. Now, when we open about our Mac, we'll see it comes up with this thing called an overview. And right now it's 2017. It's just coming into July nearly. So I'm running something called macOS Sierra. And this is bang up to date as of now. And Apple use these names to help us understand where we are within the ecosystem. So right now we're on macOS Sierra, and that's the name of software. Again, if you were a Windows guy, you'd have Windows 9, Windows 8, Windows 7, Windows XP, etc., etc. So Apple use kind of these names, which are places in California. So macOS Sierra. What's great is they change these every kind of autumn time, okay, or the fall, depending where you're from. So already we know that in the autumn we'll be getting High Sierra. So it'll be called macOS High Sierra. And basically they're always a free upgrade. So whenever Apple offer you a free upgrade, always take it. I'll show you where we're going to find that before we finish the session today. So you'll see where we'll be able to upgrade it when it does come available. And it is free. And good thing to know is that it doesn't break your existing system. So if you install it, you don't have to kind of uninstall macOS Sierra to install macOS High Sierra. Okay. Cool. So from this little window here, we'll see that that's the name of the product. It's macOS Sierra. It's on version 10.12.5. Very geeky, but don't need to that. But it also tells me about my computer. So I know I have a MacBook Pro 15-inch 2016. It's running a processor 2.7 and memory, etc. Now, obviously, I'm going to gray over this area here, but this is my serial number. Now, this is unique to my product. In other words, nobody else will have the same serial number. And from the serial number, Apple can tell you what you've actually got. So it, that's your number has, you know, that it's obviously registered to me, James, and that it is a MacBook Pro 15. It also knows where I bought it from, the date I bought it. So all my warranty is actually tied up inside of that serial number. So it's a good idea to keep that number wrote down somewhere, or maybe stored somewhere else. So if anybody takes your device, you can tell the police about your computer with that similar. So it's a good idea to write that number down right now. Just so for peace of mind, really. And it's kind of a good thing to do with any device that you own, especially from Apple. That serial number tells the Apple retail stores and online stores all about that product, which I think is pretty good. You'll see inside of here there's something called storage button as well. And I already asked kind of Siri how much storage it is, but if you didn't know, that's also going to tell us here. This really is a great one, the support page. So if you ever wondered how your Mac works or want to go a little bit further, all that resource is right there, right within inside this menu. I kind of think it's kind of hidden away up there, and it's a good idea to look a bit further and see where these buttons will take you. But basically, these are going to open up internet web pages. They're perfectly safe, and they're going to take you through your Mac. And the last bit here has got the word service. So this is regarding your Apple Care. So Apple will offer Apple Care, and basically it protects your computer for a further 2 years on a computer anyway. And the idea is that if you have any issues, be it software or hardware, so say a keyboard button falls off, or the trackpad stops working, or maybe one of your peripherals, Apple Care will cover that for 2 years. So in the UK anyway, you get a 1 year warranty. The Apple Care will extend it for a further 2 years. So via this little button page here, it will ask you to check your support, and you actually buy the Apple Care online as well. So good place to stand here, have a look at, have a good idea of what your computer's all about. But for me, that overview all tells us all about the operating system and what it's about. Okay, so that's it. That's a real quick introduction into when you first open your Mac, what you're looking at. So desktop across the front, menu bar at the top, menu bar changes depending what application you're on. We have a dock at the bottom, which has all our applications on. All we've got to do is click on one, they pop up. Okay, we can have more than one open, which is fine. We can have multiple screens open. Okay. What also you'll see is that each window has a red, yellow, and green button. The red one will close the window. Okay, so let's open that back. The yellow one will minimize it. It drops into the dock there. So it pulled all the way down to here. The idea is that by minimizing it, it's just put it into our dock so it can retrieve it at another time. There we go. And lastly, the green traffic light is green for expand. Full screen mode. Which is also handy. Now, I want to get rid of this window. So if I press the X, it closes the window. But actually, if you look in our menu bar, it's actually still open. So if I click on the word calendar, it's by pressing the red button, it's not only closed the window, but it's not actually closed the program down. So if I go to the word calendar up here, and you'll see it's got the word quick calendar. This really cool shortcut here, which is the command button. And Q. So Command Q would also quit the application. So let's go ahead and press that. Now Contacts is actually finished. Just another quick thing before I end this session. You'll see that because I have my address book open here and I have my notes open here, that in the dock at the bottom of the screen is these two very small black dots. See those two there? That's letting us know that the computer is on and that those applications are in use. So you'll notice under the notes, which is this little yellow top one, the black dot, if I go up to notes and hit the word quit notes there, it closes the program and the black dot disappears, which leaves only just the contacts one. See contacts, little black dot there. So let's go to contacts and press quit contacts. And that's it, it's actually closed. But those of you who are really looking really hard will also know under the word finder, there's also a black dot. Now, that finder tells us all about our file system and where all these programs are kept. Again, I'll be doing a tutorial on that, so I'll link it somewhere above me here so you can have a look at Finder and how that works. Finder is the only application that will always remain open. In other words, that black dot is telling us that it's running in the background and we can't switch it off. Okay, so that's it. So we've got that. I've got 13, 14 minutes of getting you up and running with your Mac. Check out my next one and it will tell us how we can go further with our Mac. So hope you enjoyed it. Any feedback is obviously welcome. You can get hold of me on Twitter at RenderBots. But otherwise, please comment below, like and share. And if you haven't already, subscribe. And I'll speak to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.